Do you want to learn how to create this cool slider crank animation with MATLAB plot and also save it as a video? Follow me step by step. First, we should know some of the dimensions. The radius is 1, the arm is 2.5, this thickness is 0.06, and you can see other dimensions. To plot this graph, we need the coordinates of these 3 points. I set this point as my origin, so its coordinate will be 0, 0. Then I have this point, which is rotating around the origin, shaping a circle with radius r. Its x coordinate is r times cosine of theta. Its y coordinate is r times sine of theta. I know r is equal to 1 and theta is changing from 0 to 2 times pi, so I start coding. R equals to 1, theta equals to linear space 0, 2 times pi, n. We need to discretize theta to n points, so I set n to, for example, 50. I name x coordinate and y coordinate of this point ax and ay. Now the coordinates of this point. This might get a little tricky. The y component of it is easy, it's e plus half of c, so it's always 0.5. But the x coordinate, it consists of these two parts. The first part is r times cosine of theta, which we named ax. But the second part, according to the Pythagorean theorem, this length is equal to the square root of a squared minus r times sine of theta minus e minus half of c. I add the constant variables and the coordinates of point b. Before we proceed to the next part, I want to ask you to like this video and subscribe to my channel, so thanks. Now I want to start plotting. Plot ax, ay as a dashed line. Our circle is plotted like an ellipse. This is due to different scaling of x and y axis. So we need to make their scales equal. I add axis equal and it's fixed. Let me add the origin to our plot. 0, 0, ko, a black O-shaped point. So far, so good. I want to add the crank. It is actually a line starting from the origin and ending in point A. So it is, hold on, plot 0, ax, 0, ay. But remember, ax and ay are vectors, so I add a for loop to plot each point one by one. It is showing all the lines together. We need to hold off at the end of each loop. I add the pause function to see the progress. Let me add a black marker at point A. Now we should plot the slider. I have the coordinates of point B, but if I plot it, the axis limits will change accordingly. So I have to fix the axis limits. Axis limits equal to minimum of ax times 1.1, maximum of bx times 1.2, minimum of ay times 1.1, maximum of ay times 1.1. So beautiful. Now the slider arm is just a line connecting A to B. So it will be plot ax of ii, bx of ii, ay of ii, by. I want to plot the slider. To plot a colorful rectangle, I use the field command. The field command receives the x and y components of a closed polygon. So I should find the coordinates from bx and by. The x coordinates are bx minus half of d, bx minus half of d, bx plus half of d, bx plus half of d, and bx minus half of d. I repeat the same process for y coordinates. And we have the slider. It is covering the B marker and the arm, so I place it here. We just gotta plot the ground on which the slider is sliding. I copy the slider X line and name it ground and modify it. I do the same for ground Y and plot it with field command. I make it green. Before we proceed to the next part, I want to ask you to like this video and subscribe to my channel, so thanks. I turn the axis off and let's save it as a video. First, using video writer command, I define a video object. This is my file name and I set the output format to MPEG-4. By default, it is .av. Then just before the for loop, I open the video object. Now frame by frame, I write them to my file. You should use write video function. The first argument is the video object we created, and the second argument is the frame, which is called by this command, get frame. I also don't need this line anymore. At the end, I close the video object. Let's take a look at the output. You may think it is so fast. Remember that our video is only 50 frames. If I increase the number of frames or decrease the frame rate per second, I can lower the video speed. Let me do both. I type video object.frame rate. It is currently 30. I want to set it to 15. So before opening the video object, I add this line. Video object.frame rate equals to 15. I also increase the number of frames to 100. As the last modification, I think it would be better if the crank would revolve 5 times. I can add another for loop and this way repeat the whole process 5 times. But there is a more efficient way. Instead of saving the frames in the video, I save the frames in a variable named frames. Now I can save the frames 5 times using a for loop. The point about write video function is that it can receive either a single frame, as we saw a minute ago, or receive an array of frames, as we see here. It is receiving all the frames at once, 5 times, and putting them all together. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial and learned a couple of things. I would be grateful if you liked this video and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.